Hello, I'm Shah, your editor, lecturer in metallurgy. I teach Christianity, Sikhism and real Islam, which is Sharia-free. Sectarian riots are on at large and they are very destructive because the Satan called Al-Djmar Al-Aksa, who excite people, who incite people on the religious grounds, that you are a Hindu, you are a Sikh, you are a Muslim, you are a Jew, and so and so. So most of the people, they don't care about religion because they know that religion causes problems and fighting and all that, what they have seen in Catholic and Protestant in the Europe. And in India, Hindu, Sikh and Muslim fighting with each other. That is all the work of the Satan. But if you know God, then you will be able to overcome this fear and unite people. My father had this knowledge. With this knowledge, 2,000 people came to attack our village in Pakistan. And when my father told the attacking headman that we tribal people going to fight and kill each other and not Muslim and Sikh, so he understood it and he asked the 2,000 people to look after us as their guests. So they did. And we became friends in Allah, much stronger friends than before. Even the headman of the attacking party said, let's go to Lahore to stop this partition. My father said, it's too late. It's too late now, it's gone too far. So we people in Pakistan and India, we are of the same tribe. Same people as in Ireland, Catholic and Protestant, they are same people. But the religious fanatics, the Dokoro priest and other, you know, priests and mullahs and other things, they are the people who incite people and make them to fight with each other. So everywhere in the world, there will be sectarian riots, except in Africa, where they have the tribal mark on their faces. They haven't forgotten their tribe. And also Brazil and Russia. Russia is a land of tribes. In Chechnya, they wanted to incite people in the name of religion. The local people crushed it down. And in Egypt, the Morsi, who was the president-elect under Muslim Brotherhood, the people put him in the jail. And in jail he died. He don't care, he's a president, doesn't matter. So in Ishmael, there's a strong instinct of tribalism of Adam and his sons. They used to worship Adam, whereas in the chosen people, Jewish people, they were making them Jew outwardly, religious fanatic. And that's why the first anointed Christ, Christ is the very son of our supernatural father, Elohim Allah Pabram. He appeared in the Middle East, in the name of Jesus, Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua, or Shiva, meaning first primordial Adam. Mary was sired by Yahweh, and Joseph was of Judah tribe, was of foster father. So, simple. The subject is very, very simple. But people make it complicated under religious color and you suffer. Now, the first anointed Christ came in Middle East, the second anointed Christ, Nanak, he came in the Punjab where I come from. And he gave a very thorough understanding of the religion. There are six candles of the menorah, and under that menorah, in India, all those aspects, religious aspects, were explained by six Christs or Satgurus. So leaving no stone unturned, just I'm trying to find the menorah. Oh dear. So religious knowledge in India is great, but the people are very greedy, crook, and over there it cannot flourish. It flourishes where the hearts are clean, and that is in the West and not in the East. So there it is. So this is the menorah, which is the fundamental of religion. These three candles here, they are of works under Yahweh. Under Yahweh you work for your living, for your food. On seventh day, which is the middle candle of God, you get together in the synagogue to learn the moral laws, which are the reflection of His word. Moses saw the face of God, he showed the back up to the people. So it's a reflection. So there were six candles and there were six Satguru Christ in India who preached on these aspects. And then those who could not be handled with the word of mouth, then sword power had to be used, and that was in the name of the middle candle of menorah, which is Elohim Allah Fabram. This candle is of righteousness, and so the soldiers, that royal king Gobind Singh had, were fighting for righteousness. Anybody who was righteous, they gave him the support to fight against the unrighteous people. There was no intention of occupying the land, because when they were initiated into the third Khalsa Panth, or the third community, then there five of them, they were beheaded on stage in front of everyone. And then the head of one was sewn with the torso of the other. And after sewing it, then the nectar was prepared. With the power of nectar, they were revived. So after being revival, they can't go to the house of the head or of the torso one, because now they have given their sacrifices for righteousness. And that was the Khalsas, not these ones with the turban and beard and living in family homes. Khalsa is not a family man. He is fully devoted to fight the tyrant are unrighteous people, cruel people, who are fanatic, religious fanatic. So, in the Middle East, cry Jesus, his preaching was limited to or concentrated upon the promised land, the children of Abraham. Abraham was picked up from Iraq area and he was made to establish himself in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah was Eve, and the promised land was given as the Garden of Eden. Through them we learn the moral laws. So we should appreciate their sacrifices and try to learn the moral laws they have presented to us. So now, as I told you, there was only last prophet was John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16. Law and prophet were till John the Baptist. And no other prophet came in the Middle East, in the Promised Land. Whereas Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, he also propagated moral laws. That's why you have moon and star stand for the moral laws. Moon and star, moral laws. This is sun, the primary source of light. Then Christ came in the name of Elohim, the middle candle of menorah. And they are saints, primary source of light, Christ. Not Christian. Christians are people of the book. They are dead in letters. Here it is. These are Christians here, down, holding Bible. Here, when you enter the royal kingdom, you need to bury the ego of your tribal ego here, to turn it into a plant, and that plant is to enter this narrow gate, which is the burning bush. And when you enter that one into the royal kingdom of God, then your soul is concerned and not your physical body. So in soul, you know, there's neither male nor female, not Jew nor Gentile, but all are representative of our supernatural Father, and the one who represents Father is Son and not daughter. So here we are all sons of the Most High. And that's why Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High above, and they are solitary virgin brides of Christ Jesus, bridegroom. So they don't follow anyone, not even Christ Jesus they follow. They are solitary, and that's why Jesus came to make us like Him, solitary. So here when you enter, take no money in your pocket, because this is no moment, sadhus, Melchizedek regime, no money in your pocket, no two shoe, no tunic, and no script. Script means Bible is forbidden, because that finished with John the Baptist. So transgression against the moral law is sin, so no sin here, but transgression against the heart, which is a blasphemy. So blasphemy prevails here, not sin. So anybody who talks about sin, he is anti-Christ. He is not free man, he is a bound man, bound by law, church law, you know, and all that thing you see them. And still, you know, they are so strictly blind and they are still putting on this dog collar and making fool of the people. So wake up, and it's end time has come. Putin is super Hitler. Hitler killed the sinner. Super Hitler is going to punish the blasphemer Tony Blair and Bush, who said that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction, but none were found by a major general, British major general, who runs a ministry now, international ministry. So that will be blasphemy against Holy Spirit, which is not forgivable. And Putin is going to punish them. Hitler killed the sinner. Sinner is concerned with flesh, that they had become unfit for Abraham, unfit for Yahweh, when they became Jew outwardly. So he punished the sinners, and super Hitler, Putin, is going to punish the blasphemers, the nations. You will find that the people in Russia, they are tribal people. They don't tell lies and other things, as you see them telling in the West, where there is no tribal instinct. So, tribal instinct gives you salt. So this is the a cartoon made by a British MP, Green Party deputy head MP. She made this cartoon and sent it to Jewish newspaper to be published. And they published it. When they published it, then Jewish people came to know, oh, this is against them. So they took it off. I get it by email. So when I got that one by email, I copied it. And it was gone after 1 hour or so. And they asked the MP to apologize, which she did very quick. Otherwise, they will destroy her career. Even today, Mammon and media is in the hand of the Jewish people, and they don't like my videos, as they do not like Christ Jesus. I am the younger brother of Christ Jesus. I preach gospel from the rooftop, and they don't like it. They like falsehood, sweet, that kill people in thousands. So this is a Jewish man putting on a sickle with the David's cross, and he is killing all people, Mammon and media. So Mammon and media is in the hand of the Jewish people, and they are liars, as Jesus told them in John 8 verse 44, that their forefathers are liars, and they are super bastard fanatic devils, murderers. And so are they murderers, as you can see them in this cartoon, how they are bringing blood from all over the countries. So, gospel is as simple as ABC. Just think logically, and you get logo, and logo is his word is God. So you have perceived God when you think logically. That is the rock bottom gospel truth over which the temple of God is built. And this is the temple of God I'm carrying with me. Not this church, you know, made of mortar and brick. That was not professed by Christ Jesus. Where two or three are gathered together, then Christ Jesus is sitting among us. So, these churches are synagogue of Satan, produced by those husbandmen. Remember the last parable of wine press. wine press is the temple where the theologians coined the moral laws, and they wrote it down. They changed it as they liked it. So, the husbandmen, when the prophets came, they beat them, they killed them, and when they saw Christ Jesus coming, they knew, because they were not once born, they were twice born crook, evil spirited people. So when they saw Christ Jesus, yeah, here come the hare. Let's get hold of him and kill him, and our all this inheritance will belong to us. So that's what they did, you know, they took hold of Christ Jesus and took him out at night and killed him. But gospel cannot be hidden down. Gospel must be preached before the end of the age. Otherwise people will say, ah, we were not aware of this and that. For awareness we are preaching gospel, and we don't seek our praises. People who seek their own praises, they are psychic, and they deliver sugar-coated sermons of falsehoods, and that causes sectarian riots on a larger scale. So I'm not a psychic politician or theologian or anything. I'm solitary, virgin bride of Christ Jesus and of Christ Nanak, second coming of Jesus. So the end of the age is approaching, and according to the Jewish people, who are the demonstration nation, they were given this Matthew 13, verse 24-30. When end of the age come, our bundle of the tares, and burn them. So these tares, Jew outwardly, who did not listen to Christ Jesus. So, for 70 years, they will be staying with us. Okay, let's 70 years, this temple was destroyed in 70 AD. It's made of 10 times 7, 70. And AD started when Jesus was in his 7th year. So the 12 laborers of Jesus had nothing to do with the 12 tribes, but with 7 of John the Baptist, in whose name he prepared 17 outer circle laborers who were going in pairs, and 5 of heart. Heart is a bound heart, attacked by 5 devils, demons. And they are immorality, anger, greed, worldly attraction, and haughtiness of the religious knowledge, book knowledge, and not by spirit, because religious knowledge in this dark age comes from God, and God is inside here. If you are not greedy, if you are greedy and looking for money, as these churches are, you know, whenever they have some function or anything, they ask for donations, or they charge money, you know. So they cannot have gospel. Judas Iscariot was thrown out at the Last Supper because he was greedy and he was stealing money from the church purse. But if he wanted to buy something, he would steal money from the church purse and spend it. For being love of Mammon, he was thrown out at the Last Supper. And that is presented that in the banquet, marriage of the son banquet, when Father comes, Christ Father, our supernatural Father, Christ Elohim Allah Pabram, then you are the sons of the Most High, and you are Christ and not Christian. That's why Jesus said, from below, Nicodemus 3, John 3, he told Nicodemus, below you teach the scripture, what this man said, that man said, what is written in this book or that book is written. And from above, we speak what we know, not we don't go by any book. We ourselves are the royal priest, are the royal priest. So we don't take any money from anyone, because to become apostles, people sold their possessions. And when you want to enter the royal kingdom above, take no money in your pocket, no shoe, no tunic. So money is not allowed. So people sold their possession to enter that fold. So I will leave it here. And above here, you need to have arrows to live with your tribal father. If you are not faithful to your tribal father, you cannot be faithful to your supernatural father. Elohim Allah Pabram. So here arrows, the love of your own same people, and here we have agape, unconditional divine love. So here you have sin, transgression against the moral laws, and here you commit blasphemy against the Holy Spirit, which is not forgivable. These sins are forgivable by the lawmakers. They can change the thing, or they can ask something additional, or so and so. So subject is as easy as ABC, but not many people are bothered about it. And if I tell them, they will be looking at books, you know, in which book it is written. Gospel is not written in the books. Gospel, you get it from God Himself, which is inside here. The inner man is called Christ. The inner man in here will teach you the gospel truth. So, this is the age of Christ. And if we are royal priests, and the top of the priest in the churches, they are the legacy of the temple priest, of the husbandman who was sacked. They created Pope and the Scribes on the line of the temple and fulfilled Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, and made the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. I hope you understand it, and we together can preach gospel. Gospel gets written over your heart and not in any book, through logical reasoning. For example, people are Levi tribe, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe. They were born, and when they died in the Holocaust, so those people who are born, they will die, not Jews. The Jew is sorry, I'm feeling sleepy.